What's up, flappers? Welcome back to another video. And today, yes, how fitting when we're talking about the game getting progressively more difficult. Zhong Li is our host today, the man himself who trivializes all level of difficulty in the game, essentially making the game playable by toddlers, even under the age of 4. So with that being said, a lot of you may think that, well, Walrus, I don't think this video is, very necessary, because difficulty level is in relevancy to your current game progression and the resources you have. So for example, Dragonspine would be monumentally more difficult if somebody has 0 pyro characters versus somebody who wailed on the game and has a ton of 5-star characters and essentially just pull out rosters to counter the mechanic. Well, yes, you are right. And this is essentially why I think it's so important to talk about this, because I think that what we just mentioned is going to be the most difficult thing for MHoYo to balance the game around as they continue to go forward. Let's get something straight here. Game progression is important. Players need a sense of resistance to their progress to make the journey feel like a process as opposed to something that is a given. Nobody wants to come in, smash through all the content, finish the game in less than a day, and be like, wow, that didn't really feel like a challenge. However, at the same time, nobody wants to get beat up in a corner, having their face kicked in by the game, feeling like there's no way for them to counteract this level of difficulty. So MHoYo has an extremely tough task to do here. Now, I have seen many people mentioning that the Dragonspine region was ruined by the sheer cold mechanic, and that one of the reasons people don't go back as often as they would like to is essentially due to the presence of sheer cold just being more of an annoyance rather than difficult. So with Inazuma, similar mechanics will be present at least in certain areas, meaning essentially it might feel like Dragonspine all over again. But here's the thing, MHoYo essentially cannot overskill enemies because everybody has different gear, everybody has different characters at different constellation levels. If they give certain mobs way too much HP, there will be players who essentially cannot defeat the monsters anymore due to the fact that they don't meet a certain threshold. But if MHoYo tunes the monsters according to the lowest common denominator, the weakest players, and make it challenging for them, well, yes, then they will find it slightly challenging and there's a bit of resistance. But then people maybe who min-max, spent on BP, spent on Welkin, had the resources, got lucky on some characters, the content becomes really easy. And then the whales just feel like it's a breeze, like it's not even there. But oh, was that the challenge? So this is why I think the solution that MHoYo has developed is to make the environment more challenging, to make the process of exploration more challenging. And even when difficult content is given to us, we are the ones who get to calibrate and select which difficulty level we would like to challenge, with people who are able to challenge more difficult content gaining more points, which essentially stacks up and helps them progress through events faster. And of course, bragging rights. Who can forget about bragging rights? So now here is the discussion topic that I want to pose to you all in the comments. How should difficulty level be measured? Well, I think it's important that we are met with resistance, but from the look of many comments, like I said before, Dragonspine's sheer cold mechanic was more of an annoyance than anything else. And I've also seen comments mentioning that as the game continues, newer regions should and will get progressively more difficult. Now, let us humor this train of thought for a moment and say that, for example, Sumeru will be harder than Inazuma. And by the time we get to Shinesnaya, we'll be fighting walking mountains and ocean dragons. Well, I'm exaggerating, but you know what I mean. So this is not necessarily a bad thing. It just means that Mondstadt, instead of being the city of freedom, will become the city of noobs. This form of linear difficulty progression can serve as a great catalyst to the Genshin storyline, guiding newer players who join down the line through an orchestrated path of exploration. While the macro of their exploration will be essentially locked behind regions and their storyline, the micros is up to them. They can go up the mountain, into the rivers of Liyue, of Mondstadt, however they want to, and slowly, as the story progresses, they move into Inazuma and how they want to explore within Inazuma before they get to Sumeru and eventually Shinesnaya is, of course, up to them. Now, if this were not true, then it would mean that players could start at Mondstadt, then skip Liyue and go into Inazuma or Sumeru and explore at their own pace. But with how the current game is looking to be set up, it seems like that would not be possible because all exploration is essentially gated behind story quests, meaning meaning that it would make way more sense for MiHoYo to make the newer regions more difficult, because as people, even newer players, would start to play the game, they would start to level up and their AR level would increase, they get more resources as they progress the story, they get more goodies, and by the time they get to these newer regions, of course they would be already powered up and looking for newer challenges. Furthermore, we have to note that one of the reasons for MiHoYo to up the difficulty level of Inazuma is because the current player base has more veterans waiting for a challenge than beginners looking to grow. Now, this is just following my point from earlier, which is saying, yes, of course the game should be getting more difficult, it should be getting more challenging, because the players are just more equipped nowadays to deal with newer challenges. And while I know people are going to be saying, like, why don't we get more challenging monsters, more challenging mobs, well, I think MiHoYo has done that, right? There has been rumors, everything is subject to change, saying that Inazuma mobs are tankier, they have new mechanics that are equipped to deal with stronger players, with stronger characters, and high scaling damage. So be ready for a slight challenge. However, for the Giga Whales, who has spent over $10,000 in the game, well, I'm sorry, they likely will not find the content challenging, because they're the highest factor in the game. The money they have spent essentially means they paid for the game to become easier. Think of it like this. Genshin Impact is a game where in its default state is extremely resource intensive and scarce with premium currencies. Everything should be done in consideration of your resources. Whereas whales essentially bypass this issue, meaning the resin system almost is a non-issue for whales. Now, this does not mean that resin doesn't exist for whales. I know there's a daily limit, and I know whales cannot be farming for 10 plus hours a day. What I'm saying is that the amount of resources that the whales get access to far exceeds the progression state of the game. And at this current rate, MiHoYo just can't develop content that is difficult or challenging enough for the current whales of Genshin Impact to be actually enjoying the game with their new power level. And it doesn't make any sense anyways, because it's just the same thing scaled upwards, right? So of course it's going to be easy for the whales, and I don't think we should be using the whales as a means to measure difficulty level in the game. But mechanics like sheer cold makes it so people don't want to go back to certain areas, just because sometimes people just want to play casually. Once they have played through the difficulty level, going back, it should feel more casual. It should feel like you're reminiscing, you're trying to relive certain moments, or you're just liking the scenery in a spot and you want to stay there for a little bit. But certain mechanics of the game makes it very difficult to do that. Now, with that being said, I think I will end the video here. Let me know what you guys think. There's going to be a stream tonight where we can sit and talk about Genshin Impact, the difficulty level if you want, follow up through this video. So with that being said, I guess I'll see you all later this evening. Until then, stay safe and peace.